In this video, I shall talk about bronchopleural fistula along with giving illustrations. BPF, as it is called, is a complication of the procedure of ICD, that is intercostal drainage. We know the pleural cavity is a potential space between the visceral and the parietal pleura, which on the other hand is lined by the intercostal muscles and the ribcage. Empyema is a collection of pus in this space. This video shows that the ICD has been placed correctly, with the ICD column moving only slightly with respiration. See clearly. Now, if by chance someone has created a BPF, how will you recognize it clinically? First is, there shall be excessive frothing or bubbling in the ICD. Next is that there will be large excursions of the ICD column with each breath of the child. In this video, you see excessive frothing in the back and the large excursions of the ICD column compared with what we had seen in the previous video. Another video showing the large excursions of the ICD column. What happens actually? Normally, the pleural cavity does not communicate with the atmosphere. Suppose you have inserted the ICD tube in such a manner that it goes beyond the pleural cavity into one of the bronchioles. When this happens, whatever air the patient breathes in during inspiration moves from the trachea into the bronchus and into the bronchiole. This in turn transmits the atmospheric pressure directly into the pleural cavity and then to the ICD, producing large excursions and bubbling in the ICD bag. Diagnosis is almost always clinical, but sometimes a CT thorax may be required. One thing which should be very clear is that a chest X-ray cannot help us decide whether BPF is there or not. For example, see this chest X-ray. One might think that ICD is piercing even the pericardium, but this is not true. This ICD is in the anterior pleura, and both the eyes of the ICD tube can be seen within the thoracic wall. Even though the ICD was pulled out slightly, there was no BPF in this case. So, an X-ray chest cannot help in making the diagnosis of BPF. BPF usually heals by self, that is the rent in the visceral pleura in communication with the bronchiole, usually heals by self, but sometimes surgery may be required. For small fistula or high surgical risk, bronchoscopic procedures like bronchoscopic closure with sealants, fibrin glue, endobronchial silicone, and metal stents would suffice. Whereas larger or chronic fistulae with complications or with complications might require even video-assisted thoracoscopic surgery or open video thoracostomy. Besides, effective antibiotics and pleural drainage are one of the mainstays of therapy, along with good nutritional care and good physiotherapy. Hope the residents are now clear what is meant by BPF and that they are more cautious next time they insert an ICD. Thank you so much.